Friends, on my OAuth video, a lot of requests came to make a second video comparing JWT versus OAuth. So in this video, we'll understand the differences, the subtle differences between these two and what is the purpose of using both. Let's start. So JWT stands for JSON Web Token. Okay. So as the name suggests, it is a token which is given to authenticate and authorize a request. So for example, you might have a front-end application, okay, which wants to send a HTTP request to your backend service, okay? So if this user which is sending this request has to be authenticated and authorized, in that case, this request from the user will go to the server and it will have its username and password, okay? So user will enter the username and password. The server will authenticate and authorize. So what is the difference between authentication and authorization? So authentication in a very simple language can be who are you? And authorization means, okay, I know who are you, but are you allowed to do this? Okay, so this is the difference between authorization and authentication. So server will then send back to the user the JWT. Now what will have in this JWT token? So imagine if this is a JWT token, JSON Web Token, it will have primarily three parts. So it will have header information, which will have the metadata and rest all the information. Then it will have the payload, where it will contain the user ID and the permissions which are granted. And then the most important is signature, so that no one can hack it. The signature will make it really secure and no one can interject and use this token except for the user to whom it has been assigned. And then all the subsequent requests with the user send would be using this token. Whatever request it wants to do, it will add that with the JSON Web Token. And this is actually in a JSON format. So for example, user ID equals ABC, then there could be permissions which will be further embedded into this particular token. But this token is in itself self-sufficient. It has everything. And it is kind of a VIP wristband which is given. So if you are going to a concert, once you have that particular wristband, anyone scans it, knows who you are and which particular row or which particular area you can access in the theater. So yeah, this is pretty much it. So JSON Web Token is the actual token which is given for, you know, authenticating and authorizing a request. So the question arises, then what is OAuth? Because these two sounds quite similar. So OAuth is not a token, but OAuth is a protocol, and this protocol enables especially third-party applications to access certain resources. Okay, so we have talked about it in detail, but just to give you a simple example, if there is a photo app and you log into that particular photo app and this photo app wants to access your Google photos, then it will ask you to enter your Google ID and password. Then this particular app, this will then first go and it will connect to the Google's authorization server, which will connect and ask the user, are you good to allow this particular app to use your photos? And if the user say yes, go ahead, allow, then authorization server will send that to the resource server, and then resource server will pass it on to the photo app. Okay, at a high level, this is how it works. And all this flow which you are seeing right now happens through this particular protocol, which is OAuth. But the thing is that in this whole flow, there is a point where authorization server gives a token, okay? And that particular token is given to the resource server. The photo app server does not understand what is that, token. But generally what happens, this token can be, in most of the cases, a JSON Web Token. And this JSON Web Token will then be sent. The photo app won't have an idea of, what is it, but it will definitely talk about what exactly, this user access profile is, what is the ID, what is their permissions, everything. Whatever is needed will be contained in your JSON Web Token and it will be sent to the photo app. But OAuth is different because OAuth is not only about this. OAuth is this whole framework of accessing certain, aspects or certain data resources from your maybe Google photos or from any of your applications. So OAuth enabled that, and that's why it is very famous when you are trying to get third-party applications to integrate with your application. So OAuth becomes that kind of a protocol. So JWT, yes, it can work, but then OAuth is a bigger framework in which JWT or JSON Web Token plays a part. But you can have other tokens as well which could be replaced by JWT based on the resources. So yeah, this is the basic difference between JSON Web Token and OAuth. So basically, just to summarize, JWT is actually a thing, okay, which gets passed. But if you talk about OAuth, OAuth is a process, protocol, or we can say framework. Second difference could be JWT is like a ID card. Okay, so that card has all the information, and the moment anyone scans it, it knows that, okay, so this particular access card has all the information, who is the user, what is he or she can do. Whereas OAuth could be like a valet key. So when you go to a hotel, you give your valet key to the driver to drive the car, but you don't give them all the keys, your house key, your store key, no, nothing. You only give the key which is required to do that specific job. So OAuth is very good in that. Now JWT can be used in OAuth, and OAuth can have JWT as a token, but both are working in sync. So both work in sync, not opposite to each other. So you will be using both in tandem based on your use cases. JWT, again, I don't want to repeat much, but it is a mechanism with which you pass on the thing, and that mechanism with which you pass on the thing is OAuth, not all the workflow. So JWT can be used in non-OAuth workflow as well. Okay, so even if you have a simple front end, a back end service, you can use JSON Web Token for your internal services as well. And similarly, OAuth can have other tokens, not only JWT. So both can use bits and pieces of each other based on the use cases. So friends, I hope now you know what is JWT versus OAuth and what are the subtle differences between the two. If you like this video, let me know in the comment what you would want to learn next. Give a like, give a subscribe for us to grow this channel. Let me know what else you want to learn, guys. It really helps me brainstorm and come up with new ideas, new research every time. So until next time, keep learning, keep sharing, and keep growing. Bye for now.